Thanks so much for your time. What do you make of your performances so far? People are saying it's quite surprising that you're doing so well.
It's looking very good at this stage. The total number is showing for now 104,000 is more than we have in the total in 2014, where we have end with 106,000. So a percentage where we end in 2014 with 0.901% is now more. We are standing at currently at 3.36% at this stage, and at this stage it looks very well for Freedom Front Plus.
And of course it is early days, so I mean this number is expected to go higher. Who do you think you're taking the votes from?
Well, if you look at the provincial ballots who's on the boards now, it looks like that we are eating into the votes of the DA. There's many voters who was in the DA who were coming over to us and voting for us this year. There can be many factors to it. But yeah, probably my main votes came from the DA, which we have taken away from them.
I mean, top of your mind, why do you think the previous DA supporters have crossed over to you?
Well, like I said, there's many factors you can take in consideration why it happened. But one main consideration is that the DA was not attending to a certain group anymore on the ground level and just shift their attention permanently to another certain group of a population in this country. And I think that people felt neglected and they see a new home in the Freedom Front and they came home to us.
I mean, correct me here if I'm wrong, if we just try and unpack that certain group, it sounds like you're referring to your traditional Afrikaner community, those that are in support of us keeping the old South African flag, those who are definitely against land expropriation without compensation. But do tell me now, what is your position on how we take South Africa forward in a manner that is inclusive so that there isn't so much division, which ultimately is a big setback for us?
Look, our standpoint of view is clearly we don't believe in the old apartheid system. That's the Freedom Front Plus point of view. We believe in the democracy, a better South Africa for everyone in this country, and that's what we are striving for, to help build a better country for everyone.
But then that means that, you know, I mean, the issue of the flag shouldn't even be an issue. We should just put, you know, that as far underground as possible, if that's what you're saying, given the emotions and the tones that flag does raise amongst those who were oppressed by the old apartheid system.
Look, our standpoint of view on the old flag issue is it's something which was happened in the past. It's part of the history of this country. You can't demolish the history before the democracy in 1994. We must know what happened in the history throughout. You can't change the history, and that is going to take us forward. But we also say, stop living in the past and look for a better future on forward. That is our standpoint of view.
All right, Philip, you guys got 4 seats in Parliament last election. How many are you hoping to get this time around?
Well, we're hoping to get, at this time when all the ballots is being counted, up to 15. That's our positive way of thinking, I think, and I think we'll be able to achieve it.
I mean, quite a big jump, but yes. The question is, what are you planning to do with those increased seats?
Well, if we get that big increase in National Assembly, we will show South Africans and thank South Africans who have voted for us yesterday. And we will show them the next coming 5 years what difference we will be making into the government system in South Africa. And for sure, they can depend on us for anything, and we will help build a better South Africa forward.
All right. How? Because right now, South Africa needs to grow.
Yes.
It's too low. South Africans
yes.
need jobs. Too many are unemployed.
Yes.
South Africans need to be uplifted out of poverty. So how exactly are you going to deliver on that promise?
We can go and read our manifesto we had for this election. One key point is we must give attention to education in this country. That is one key point. The infrastructure, municipalities, everything is currently directing in South Africa, we will give attention to it. If we're part of a coalition government of national level, we will see to it that our manifesto is implemented in that coalition government and to fix South Africa. Because if we don't fix South Africa, we're all going to go under at the end of the day, and we're all going to suffer, and we're all going to suffer under a bad economy.
For sure. And who would you be willing to get in bed with by way of coalition?
It's very early days. I think let's wait for the total ballots to be counted, and then that talks will start.
I mean, if the DA wants some of its people back and says let's talk, would this be something that you're open to?
Well, like I said, let's wait until all the ballots is counted for.
Okay. But ultimately, I mean, your message needs to be a strong one, particularly to the investment community, because you're not going to be able to achieve any of, or very little of the things that you want without a more growth in this economy. And that growth is seen as, or is believed that the private sector will inject quite a lot of it. What is your message to investors, and you know why they should trust your mandate in terms of putting money in South Africa's economy?
Well, I think the clear message for investors from international, which internationally will be this. But if a coalition government take over this national government after these ballots have been counted, South Africa will get on a stabilizing track, not unstabilizing as it is currently under ANC government. And for sure everything will be fixed, the economy will grow, and we must attend to certain matters which is keeping the economy under certain policies of the ANC. So the coalition government will go first and look at those policies and maybe implement new policies to make South Africa attractive for international investors. We have a problem in Gauteng, if I can just point on Gauteng quickly. Gauteng is not attractive enough for international investors. But the problem now is this. Gauteng's only income, 98% of Gauteng's income per year is from National Department of National Treasury. Gauteng's only own income is 3% is from motor license renewals every year in Gauteng. That is a problem. So if the money dries up on National Treasury level, Gauteng is in big trouble. So that is that's not only Gauteng, that's the figures I can give you for Gauteng. But the other provinces have the same problem. That's why we need to make South Africa attractive for international investors. And we can only do that when this government has changed after the votes have been counted.
Okay, perfect. And remind us again, I mean, you're saying that you want to go ahead in a manner that is beneficial for all. How would you tackle the issue of land reform and addressing the inequalities in that space?
Well, the Freedom Front stand of point of view is very clear about that. We said from the beginning, the way that national government has handled the land reform project was not good enough. They've made many mistakes. You can't give land to people who can't work the land. You must train them to work the land. We've seen in the previous past years that land was given to people by government and they was not trained. Those farms were neglected and there's nothing anymore from it over of it left. So we are, but you know, the Freedom Front standpoint of view is about land expropriation without compensation. We say no, because this is going to harm the economy very much if this policy is going to be implemented with the ANC government if they are in power again. The economy will suffer very much under that policy of land expropriation without compensation. And we must, as South Africans and politicians, be very careful what we are going to do with that policy. And the Freedom Front point of view is we're not going to support that policy at all.